in this kind of a situation, the civil society is not a homogeneous group. It's actually very diverse, and therefore, this diverse civil society groups cannot apply a cookie cutter approach in advocating the policy needs. So there is a very broad spectrum of NGOs and civil society groups, but I will divide them basically into two categories. One is the established high-profile medical groups like the cancer societies and the lung associations, the thoracic associations, and then the diabetes, you know, it's like the organ groups and the disease groups. And then on the other hand, you've got the newer NGOs that work specifically on tobacco control, like in ASH in Thailand, Movement for Tobacco Control in Cambodia, or SIATCA, the organization I work for, which is more of a regional organization, regional alliance. So the issue here is that the newer tobacco control advocacy groups are more flexible, because they do not have this kind of a fixed bureaucratic structure, so you can't put all of us into one boat. Having said that, I think that the older, more established medical groups, perhaps as you pointed out, Dilip, are more focused on the curative side, and they therefore deal with governments on their area of expertise. And yes, tobacco control is perhaps one of the things that they do. And the Cancer Society in Malaysia, for example, is quite different from, say, in Australia or in the US, where they have long taken on the tobacco issue, whereas it's only in recent times that the Cancer Society in Malaysia, for example, has come on board. But and on the other hand, the tobacco control groups are there running off doing public health. It comes under the domain of public health, and so more on the preventive side and looking at policies. But I also want to say that recently the medical groups in Malaysia came on board in a wonderful way to support the Malaysian government on the carve out for tobacco on the Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement.